The caravan is prepared. We may now journey eastward to loot Golain.
And into the vast deserts of broken lands. As the days passed, my companion told me of himself, that he had once been a great warrior, and that a dark and secret burden now weighed heavily upon him. We traveled for an eternity across that arid wasteland. How long ago? I couldn't say, and always a dark cloud seemed to follow us just over the horizon. Finally, the journey ended. We climbed the last bridge. There below us lay our destination, the shining jewel loot lane, with a great sea beyond. We made camp that last night. Perhaps it was the warm desert wind or the sound of the ocean, but for the first time in many weeks, I slept. However, the dreams returned, but these were clearly not my own. I beheld a vision of a great man, the mage, Talrasha. You were there too, Tyriel. I remember seeing you in my dream. His brethren had cornered a great demon, Baal, Lord of Destruction, who had been set loose upon the world. They attempted to imprison the demon within a sacred stone. Yet when their attempts failed, Talrasha selflessly volunteered to contain the demon within himself, completing the prison. He instructed his brethren to bind him within a tomb, buried under the sand, there to wrestle with the demon for all eternity.
Now you know what I seek, Marius. This is my brother. Sleep now. We set out with the dawn.
The next morning, we walked over the hill toward Loot Golain. I had no idea then of the horrors that were in store for me there.
Good day. Greetings, honored traveler. I am Jaren, Lord of Loot Golain, and I bid you welcome to my fair port city. I'm glad to know that once again, caravans are free to travel through the Western Pass. For some time now, we have been under siege by an evil power that I cannot identify. Strange, it all began when a dark wanderer came this way, looking for the tomb of Talrasha. No one knows exactly where Talrasha, Keeper of Baal, is entombed, but it is certain to be far out in the desert. Now my people whisper tales of the dead rising from their tombs, and horrible creatures lurking amongst the moonlit dunes. Even I have witnessed things which I cannot explain. I've ordered the port closed and all trade ships moored until I am sure that my city is safe. Atma, the tavern keeper, has an important mission for you. Go see her immediately. You'll find her on the other side of town. Now I must return to the palace. I apologize, but I can't invite you in. Things are rather a mess right now. For trade in magic and the like, see Drognan or Lysander. Drognan is the wisest man I know, without equal in magic and ancient lore. Poor Lysander is nearly deaf, but he's a reliable potion chemist. or travel back west, Siwariv, whom you already know. Our own Farah is a fine and honest armorer, and she can heal wounds as well. Elzix is the innkeeper, and may also have some items to trade. Greys, the mercenary captain I hired to secure the gates of Lut Golain, keeps order in town as well. There are others here too. I'm sure you'll meet most of them. Just look around. When you arrived, Wariv's caravan had been long overdue. With all of the evil that's arisen in the land, I'm surprised he got through it all.
Now that Andariel is dead, I can return and outfit the rogues properly. Once I've made some trades here, I'll be free to head back to their monastery. Let me know if you want to travel along. Stay a while and listen. Elzix is quite a scoundrel, but I like him all the same.
Welcome, Brother Paladin. I am Farah. I was once a devout champion of Zakharum. Good day. Welcome, Brother Paladin. I am Farah. I was once a devout champion of Zakharum. Perhaps in time, you will play a part in reclaiming our Order's honor and spirit. You are an inspiration to me, Brother Paladin.
I don't expect this of you, but if you want to help me, I would be grateful. In the sewers below our city, there lurks a horrid creature that hungers for human flesh. The creature has killed many, including my son and my husband. If you destroy it, I will reward you. Please, be careful though. That beast has taken enough from us already. The sewer entrance is through the trapdoor, just up the street. The creature makes its lair in the tunnels beneath the city. He butchered my husband and son. I simply cannot bear to talk about it. In addition to my public house, there used to be several brothels doing business here. When the troubles first started in the desert, the Harem Guild sought sanctuary within the palace. Of course, Jaren was glad to oblige. I'll bet they're finding many ways to repay him for his protection.
Pestering me. Graze seems to have this place locked down nice and tight. Not that I couldn't have done the same. I've proven my valor in combat plenty of times. Hey! Don't touch my drink, or I'll bore a hole into your skull with my thumb. I've killed plenty of those demons out in the desert. It doesn't seem to slow them down any, though. They just keep coming back for more.
I've heard that you are responsible for banishing Undariel back to the Burning Hells. I'm impressed, stranger. That couldn't have been easy. My name is Drognan, and I know what you're up against, my friend. You ought to look over my inventory of items for trade. When the recent troubles began, Lord Jaren came seeking my counsel. I advised him to close the port and put the town under strict watch. Lately, though, he's been occupied within the palace. I doubt his whores could divert him from his civic duties for this long, though. Farah and I have been talking about the creature recently. From my studies, I have deduced that it is Rodimant the Fallen, an ancient Haradric mummy that has for some reason left his tomb to prey on mortals. I'm doing some more research now. If you check back later, I may have some more insight as to his nature.
Thank you.
I bet you wonder how this town manages to stay safe with all the trouble going on out in the desert. Well, I can tell you that it's got nothing to do with the local town guards. They're all in the palace for some reason. Jaren hired me and my mercenaries to help keep the peace around here. We're not cheap, but we're the best this wasteland has to offer.
Like a sturdy adventurer. You know, I used to be quite the scoundrel in my day. I led the fiercest group of bandits who ever terrorized these sands. Nowadays, I run this here inn and pretty much stay out of trouble. My days of adventuring are behind me. You may not pass.
How do I know I can trust you, You may be as shifty as that pack rat Elzix who runs the inn. But if you need a potion, though, I suppose I can make you one. For a price, of course.
silver boot.
Greetings.
Good to see you.
Greetings. I'm Mashif, captain of this ship here. I make port runs around the Twin Seas and occasionally out to Kingsport in Westmarch. I haven't sailed anywhere lately, though. Jaren has ordered me to stay docked here in case of emergency.
Huh?
Greetings.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Need some help? Thank you.
say that the taste of vengeance is bittersweet, but I find it to my liking. In addition to my undying gratitude, I have spoken on your behalf with the rest of the townspeople. The merchants have agreed to show their gratitude by offering their wares and services at lower rates. Oh, Jaren wants to see you too. You'll find him in front of the palace. Good day.
Turn of events. As the last living Horodrim, I alone have knowledge of its meaning. Now, to read the Horodric runes it bears. The Horodric mages, after binding Bale within Tal Rasha, magically sealed off his burial chamber from the mortal realm. Those same mages also crafted fearsome Horodric staves, and imbued them with the special power to open the chamber's hidden door. After nearly losing one to the thievery of a rogue sorcerer, they divided all the Horodric staves into two parts, wooden shaft and metal headpiece, hiding them separately to safeguard them. The Horodrim foresaw our current plight and designed the hiding places to reveal themselves to worthy heroes like you. Collect both parts of a Horodric staff and unite them using a Horodric cube. Then you may enter Tal Rasha's burial chamber.
Good day. I have heard of your many deeds of skill and bravery. I feel I can trust you with something I have been hesitant to speak of. Drognan and I have concluded that the Dark Wanderer who passed through here recently was Diablo himself. Drognan believes that Diablo is searching the desert for the secret tomb where the great Horodric mage Tal Rasha keeps Bale imprisoned. You must find Diablo and put an end to the terrible evil that has fallen upon our city. Drognan is wise and is sure to have some helpful advice for you as to how Tal Rasha's tomb may be found. It may take you quite some time to find the tomb. May you be ready when you do.
When Tal Rasha chose to embody the spirit of Bale, he knew his doom was to wrestle eternally against the will of the greater evil. Look around you and ask yourself, has the battle been won or lost?
Approach and let's trade.
carrying. I can't carry anymore.
Good day.
How may I help you?
Thank you.
Good evening. It is an honor to serve you.
don't carry any more. I am overburdened.
Thank you.
I can't carry anymore.
Greetings.
Thank you.